In this question, we're asked to match the graph on the left with the correct function on the right. And we're told the black graph is the parent function. So this black graph here is our parent function, and we should recognize this as a square root function. So our parent function is f of x equals the square root of x. And this question is a review of reflections across the x and y axis, as well as horizontal stretches and compressions. So if we take a look at the black graph and compare it to the green graph, notice how it's a reflection across the x-axis. And if we compare the black graph to the red graph, notice how it's a reflection across the y-axis. And then comparing the black graph to the blue and pink function, it is sometimes hard to tell if the transformation is a vertical stretch or compression or a horizontal stretch or compression, but in this case we know it's going to be a horizontal stretch or compression. So the blue graph is a horizontal compression of the black graph, where it's compressed in this direction. And the pink graph is a horizontal stretch of the black graph. So before we match these up, let's do a quick review on reflections and horizontal stretches and compressions. Y equals negative f of x, or the opposite of f of x, reflects f of x across the x-axis. So if our parent function is f of x equals the square root of x, and we graph the opposite of f of x, or negative square root x, notice how it reflects the parent function across the x-axis. One way to remember this is, by changing the sign of the function, remember the function values are y values, so we're changing the sign of the y coordinates, therefore reflecting the function across the x-axis. If we have y equals f of negative x, this reflects the parent function across the y-axis. Notice in this case we're changing the sign of the x coordinates. So if we have f of negative x, or square root of negative x, notice how if we change the sign of the x coordinates, it'll reflect the parent function across the y-axis. Okay, and now for the horizontal stretches and compressions, this is a little bit more involved. If y equals f of b times x, where b is greater than 1, this will compress the graph of the parent function horizontally by a factor of 1 over b. So if we have g of x equals f of 2 times x, which would be the square root of 2x, this will be a horizontal compression, or it'll compress the blue graph horizontally so it looks like the green graph. And then if we have y equals f of bx, where b is between 0 and 1, this will stretch the graph horizontally by a factor of 1 over b. So for example, if we have h of x equals f of 1 half x, which would be the square root of 1 half x, or the square root of 0.5x, this would be a horizontal stretch, so we would take the blue graph and stretch it horizontally in this direction, forming the red graph. So going back to our example, let's start with the reflections across the x and y axis, which we should recognize would be function A or function B. Let's look at B first. If g of x equals the square root of negative x, again we're changing the sign of the x coordinates, which means it would reflect the black graph across the y-axis. So b would be the red graph. Therefore, for g of x equals the opposite or negative square root x, we'd be changing the function values of the y-values, therefore it's going to reflect the black graph across the x-axis, so the graph of this function would be the green graph. So now we're left with C and D, which will be horizontal stretches or compressions. Well, when the coefficient of the x here is greater than 1, it's going to be a horizontal compression, which means it'll take the black graph here and compress it horizontally, forming this blue graph. And in comparison, when we have g of x equals the square root of 0.25x, notice that b is between 0 and 1, this will be a horizontal stretch, which in this case, if we take the black graph and stretch it horizontally, we would have the pink graph. While I do realize you could just graph these on the graphing calculator and then match them, the idea here is to be able to recognize the type of transformation just by looking at the function. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.